your exclusive 7 Storm Team forecast.
And the old sleep tight weather view this afternoon takes us just up to our northern neighbors, not too far up the road from Macomb, actually. This is Cameron, Illinois, just east of Monmouth, and you can see the tornado rip through the area last night, and we're getting preliminary damage reports now of EF2 damage that is the equivalent of about 120 mile per hour winds. And we saw what 70 mile per hour winds did in Quincy here a few days ago. Just imagine 120 mile per hour in the poor community up there in Cameron. So our thoughts go out to the relief effort to our neighbors to the north. Well, the big story of the day here in the tri-states is that heat. Our official high today was 93 degrees in Quincy. That is 7 degrees above our average. Our low this morning only fell to 75 degrees. So really that humidity keeps that warmth in the air, does not allow that temperature to drop whatsoever. The allergy index, the mold kind of sneaking back up there just a little bit, up past the moderate category. A little bit of weed pollen out there as well. The satellite and radar not showing much at all. It is a dry day. The sun is out, and that is warming things up. Currently 90 degrees still in Macomb. Still got that sunshine out there. You can see on the blue sky on the cam here, that dew point is 77 degrees. Very, very, very high humidity levels out there, making it feel very, very, very hot. Same story holds true across the tri-state area. Here you can see everyone in the low 90s still this time. 95 degrees out in Hannibal in that heat indices. This is what it feels like right now. Still hanging on to heat indices well over 100 degrees across the tri-states. We're going to do it all over again. Here's the model's forecast for the heat indices tomorrow. Again, we're going to get up close to 110 degrees in many spots across the tri-state area. Yuck. Do have heat advisories across the entire area. Now, this is going to last until tomorrow at 8 p.m., so the hot weather and the humidity will continue. It's all because we're on the south side of this lifting warm front. The southerly humid air winds are coming in. And eventually what's going to happen is a cold front's going to start to sneak into our area. It's going to try and trigger off some storms by tomorrow evening, late tomorrow evening, I'm thinking, especially for our northern viewers. And then with all that instability in the air, could see maybe some isolated severe weather. By Sunday, the cold front drops more into our area. And yeah, you could see that we could have some widespread showers and thunderstorms. Again, some of those could be on the stronger side with all the instability in the air. Storm Prediction Center does have a slight risk to our north tomorrow. By Sunday, that slight risk is going to be directly over our area here. And yeah, not quite showing here, I'm not sure why, but trust me on this. The slight risk of severe weather is directly over our area for Sunday. So low temperatures tonight, not going to drop off very much at all. Talking about temperatures getting only into the mid to upper 70s, perhaps, for lows. High temperatures, very similar today, lower 90s, but added in that humidity, and it's going to feel well over 100 degrees. The 7-day forecast. Talk about chance of storms, showers and thunderstorms. For our, the best chance is going to be for our very northern viewers, and it's going to be late in the evening. By Sunday, everybody gets in on the action as the cold front moves into our area. After the cold front, however, might be some lingering storms on Monday, but we'll cool down a little bit, get more to seasonal averages, and hopefully we can have a nice, quiet, cool, dry week for the week coming up, because you know what, after all the thunderstorms and the heat and the craziness, I just think that everyone just needs a little bit of a break personally.
We're ready for a break. I can speak on behalf of everyone listening.
Okay, good.
Thanks.
We've been talking a little